Welcome to all. In this video, we are detailing about the subject fluid mechanics. Fluid mechanics is defined as the branch of the science that deals with the study of fluid either at rest or at motion. Based on the nature of fluid, the fluid mechanics branch can be broadly classified into fluid statics and fluid dynamics. Fluid statics is the study of fluid at rest, whereas fluid dynamics is the study of effects of force on fluid which is on motion. Fluid mechanics has got a wide range of application in our day-to-day life. It's been used in calculating the flow of water through a pipe, flow of water through ducts or canals. Fluid mechanics has got application in checking the air pressure of a car tire. It has got application in designing and fabrication of the body of an aircraft or a car to reduce its drag and increase its efficiency. It has got application in designing and fabrication of hot air balloons. Fluid statics. Fluid statics, as we discussed before, is the study of fluid at rest. Under the topic fluid statics, there comes the properties of fluid, pressure and its measurement, buoyancy and flotation. Under the topic properties of fluid, we will discuss about the basic properties that governs the flow of a fluid, viscosity, thermodynamic properties of fluid. Then last, we will discuss about surface tension and capillarity. Let's start our point of discussion with chapter 1, basic properties of fluid. Basic properties of fluid. On the chapter basic properties of fluid, we are going to initially discuss about what do you mean by density or mass density. Then we will explain what is specific weight, specific volume, and at last specific gravity. Now come into density or mass density. Density is defined as the ratio of mass of the fluid to its volume. It's denoted by the Greek letter rho. Rho is equal to the mass of the fluid by volume of the fluid. To understand this concept of density, let us consider a cube with side 1 meter each, so that its total volume becomes 1 meter cube. Now fill the cube with water and we weigh it, so that we get a total of 1000 kilogram weight. Hence, the density of water is equal to 1000 kilogram per meter cube. The density is actually the amount of mass contained in a unit meter cube of liquid. Specific weight or weight density. Specific weight of a fluid is defined as the ratio between the weight of the fluid to its volume. Earlier, density or mass density is the ratio between mass of the fluid to its volume. Now, in the case of weight density, it is the ratio of weight to its volume. It can be expressed by the small letter W. W equal to the weight of the fluid by volume of the fluid. We can express the specific weight or weight density in the form of mass density, because we know that weight is the product of mass and acceleration due to gravity. Hence, the specific weight W equal to mass of the fluid into G by volume of the fluid. Hence, the expression become specific weight W equal to rho into G. Specific volume of a fluid. Specific volume of a fluid is defined as the volume of fluid occupied by unit mass of a fluid. Specific volume in expression is equal to the volume of fluid by mass of the fluid. It can be expressed in terms of density as the reciprocal of density, that is 1 by rho. To understand this concept, let us take a case. Let us take a bubble of 1000 containing water of 1000 kilogram mass. Now, if we immerse that bubble into a container containing another liquid, it will displace a liquid of volume 1 meter cube. Hence, the 1000 kilogram mass of water will displace a volume of 1 meter cube. Hence, the volume displaced by a unit kilogram of water is 0.01. So, the specific volume of water is equal to 0.01 meter cube per kilogram. The specific volume is the volume occupied by unit mass of a fluid. Specific gravity. Specific gravity is defined as the ratio of weight density of a fluid to weight density of a standard fluid. In the case of liquids, the standard fluid is taken as water, whereas in the case of gases, the standard fluid is taken as air. Hence, the specific gravity in expression S is equal to weight density of a liquid to weight density of a water. Actually, specific gravity is introduced to relate the weight density of any liquid to that of water. So if we know the specific gravity of any liquid, then we can readily calculate its weight density by simply multiplying the specific gravity with weight density of water that we already know. Hence, the weight density of a liquid is equal to the product of specific gravity and weight density of water. We can split the weight density of water into the product of mass density of water and acceleration due to gravity g. Hence, the weight density of a liquid is equal to product of its specific gravity into 1000 into 9.8.